hanging off. You see MotoGP riders do it. I sometimes do it. You probably do it. But how does it work? Why should we do it? And is it really as effective as we think it is? Let's figure this stuff out. So why do we even lean our motorcycles into the corners in the first place? Well, when we enter a corner, friction generates a centripetal force at the center of the contact patch. This generates a torque around the combined center of gravity of the motorcycle and the rider, which wants to tip the motorcycle out of the corner. Well, let me demonstrate. When we lean our motorcycles into the corner, this creates a torque which counteracts the torque trying to tip us out of the corner.
The torque needed at a given speed and corner radius can be measured by the displacement of the center of gravity from the center of the contact patch. This center of gravity is combined from the rider's center of gravity and a motorcycle center of gravity into what is called a combined center of gravity.
So that is how hanging off reduces the lean angle of the motorcycle. But the question is, how much does it actually reduce the lean angle? I took two approaches to answering this question. My first approach was to do empirical studies. My second approach was to do equations around how far the rider can hang off from the bike and how much effect that actually has on the torque around the combined center of gravity.
My first study consisted of riding through the same corner over and over, alternating between hanging off and being neutral on the bike. I did everything I could to retain the same speed and line. I then measured the lean angles by looking at the video and aligning a line with roughly the center of the tire. This quick study showed that on my Aprilia Tuono, I could reduce the lean angle by roughly 4 degrees from the 39 degree angle needed when not hanging off. Next up, I studied footage of me chasing a local racer, Gia, around the go-kart track nearby. We're both on 2019 Husqvarna FS450s. Gia also does road racing and is seriously fast. He has a very smooth superbike riding style hanging off. I am using a dirt bike riding style, pushing the bike down beneath me, which as we already know requires more lean angle. We had almost identical lap times and cornering speed. Looking at this corner, where we had almost identical lines and corner speeds, I had to lean the bike roughly 5 more degrees. While both of these studies are very interesting and telling, I still wasn't satisfied. We have to remember that the camera lens, as well as the angle from which the photograph was taken, distorts the perspective. Furthermore, my way of measuring with a line wasn't very reliable.
So in my next study, I wanted to collect data in a way that removes my personal judgment as much as possible. Well, I have an AIM Solo, which I can measure lap times with, and a GoPro, which collects video, as well as data on lean angle and speed, which you can extract from the camera and then map over the video as it's playing.
Previously, I recorded a video comparing lap times for hanging off versus going foot out on a supermoto. That particular study showed that both styles rendered almost identical lap times, and that the fastest style for me was to mix between them. By using a tool from Race Technology, I was able to extract this data, which can be overlaid on the video and also exported in pure numbers. Oh, and by the way, they did not sponsor or have anything to do with this video. I analyzed every corner in detail, compared between the styles, and I must say, my mind was blown.
What?
I had learned something new. Now, before I tell you my findings, here are some clips with the lean angle overlaid. Remember to observe my lean angle throughout the corners. Are you surprised? There isn't much difference in lean angle. Remember what I said earlier, the lap times are almost identical. So what is going on here? I started looking at the corners in detail, trying to figure out if I go faster or slower in certain corners. It turns out that I on average was 0.1 seconds faster in long sweepers hanging off, and 0.1 seconds faster in sharp slow corners going foot out. Furthermore, I found out that I generally have less lean angle in the long sweepers going foot out. That's right, less lean angle. And a sharp spike in lean angle when going foot out in sharp slow corners. The difference in lean angle was generally very small. In some places, I saw spikes in lean angle if I made mistakes, both when hanging off and going foot out. So what really had a major influence on my lean angle then, if it wasn't my body position?
Well, according to the data, my speed and line. This is the lateral acceleration at a certain speed at a certain corner radius, according to physics.
Notably, I was faster in long sweepers hanging off, and 0.1 seconds per corner is quite a lot of difference. Then again, I had less lean angle and less speed in those corners, going foot out. If I at least would have had the same lean angle but less speed, it would have been obvious that my body position physically enabled me to go faster. But this wasn't the case.
So I like to hang off in long sweepers because it gives me more confidence. This is interesting because I've crashed many times hanging off. I've never actually crashed going foot out into a corner. Nevertheless, I usually hang off when I'm going fast, and especially on big tracks, I usually hang off in all of the corners, simply because it gives me more confidence. My last study was to try and figure out if I could calculate the reduced lean angle based on the displacement of the combined central gravity for a given motorcycle and rider. Even though the results of my empirical studies were clear, there could be riders like, for instance, Marc Marquez, who hang off really far, further than I do. And therefore, maybe they are able to significantly reduce the motorcycle's lean angle. It would also be interesting to see if my calculation is comparable with the empirical data. First, I study how much torque is generated by the combined central gravity for the motorcycle and rider from 5 to 70 degrees of lean angle.
To know what the height of the central gravities are, I first looked up data provided by Tony Foe.
Then I found some studies showing that humans have a center of gravity that's located roughly above their navel when they're sitting.
I sat on my Aprilia RS250 and measured how far it is from the saddle to slightly above my navel. Then we also needed a tire size. To simplify things, I assumed the tires have a round profile, and then I averaged out the front and rear. We need this because we need to figure out where the center of the contact patch is. The R6's wet weight is 188 kilograms or 414 pounds. And my own weight plus gear is about 95 kilograms or 210 pounds. Next up, I measured how far to the side I could move off of my RS250. I can move out about 200 millimeters or 7.9 inches. Now we can calculate the torque generated by the motorcycle and rider with the rider hanging off for 5 to 70 degrees of motorcycle lean angle. Then we simply compare the torques generated and calculate the effective lean angle. If I would ride a Yamaha R6, hanging off 200 millimeters would give me between 5.3 and 1.9 degrees of less lean angle. Given my previous findings, this sounds very reasonable. Okay, now let's plug in all the numbers for my Aprilia Tuono. At 40 degrees lean, I should get about 4 degrees. The studies I did previously show that I get about 4 degrees at 39 degrees of motorcycle lean angle. Now let's plug in all the numbers for my Husky. Again, reasonably consistent with the data I collected. For kicks, let's plug in Marc Marquez on the Honda RCV. I'm guessing about the height of the COG, of course, but this is just for fun. He would be able to reduce his lean angle between 7.5 and 2.3 degrees. Looking at the equation, he gets more reduction because his bike is so light and he can hang off so far.
Let's summarize. My studies show that body positioning or hanging off only slightly reduce the motorcycle's lean angle. What drives the lean angle is the speed and line through the corner. I go faster hanging off in long sweepers. And I go faster having a neutral body position in tight corners. So there might be some beginner riders out there right now thinking, does this mean that I shouldn't hang off? Well, I think you should do what makes you feel comfortable. Just remember that hanging off does not significantly reduce the lean angle of the motorcycle. What significantly reduces the needed lean angle through a corner is your line and your speed. So remember the old saying, go slow in, fast out. If you do that, physics will be on your side.
As far as racing goes, whatever produces the fastest lap times for you is the best way to do it. Anyone who races, like myself, knows that the more confident you are in the corners, the faster you go. I personally feel more comfortable hanging off in long sweeping corners, even though I know that I'm factually not reducing the lean angle that much.
I hope this video has sparked an interest in you in motorcycle dynamics and science. remember to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification button so that you know when I'm posting new videos. There's always something new to learn.
It's gotta be against the law to look this damn good. Cause baby, I feel real good and I wish I would. It's gotta be against the law to look this damn good. Everybody watch out. Watch out now. I'm ready for a good time, and I came to groove. The whole band's here, and we came to move. Got a fresh haircut and two new shoes. We're here all night like we got nothing to lose. Coming out the jacket, cause we're turning up the heat.